Appreciate you coming. Obviously, an exciting day for Delaware football. You know, around the office, we talk about 2014 being the year of the Blue Hen, and certainly today we feel like it's a great start. And again, a lot of the other programs at Delaware are doing the same thing. Monte's got it rolling. Tina, it's been a terrific start to the year, and we're all excited. Just take a couple seconds to thank some people. You know, recruiting here is a big endeavor, and you know, I'll just talk a little bit of an opening statement, and then we'll deal with the recruits that we signed. You know, we're absolutely thrilled with the new additions to the University of Delaware football family. You know, this recruiting cycle has been a blast. I mean, more fun than I've had recruiting in my entire career. I want to start by thanking all the people involved with the process who've helped us, you know, achieve what I think is a tremendous result for the University of Delaware's football program. We have an all-hands-on-deck mentality in regards to recruiting, and that ties into our motto of Together We Will. You know, bear with me as I thank these people, and I tried to write them down so I wouldn't forget anybody. I'm going to start with the university administration. You know, President Harker, his executive team, you know, they work tirelessly to provide us with the resources that we need to be successful and competitive on a national level. Our athletic director, Eric Ziadi, and his staff, again, they provide us the support, not only the individual help with specific recruits on recruiting weekends, but obviously the facilities and the resources that you need to be competitive nationally. Joe Shirley, our facilities director, Sue Groff, Vess Johnson, they do an unbelievable job for us on our recruiting weekends and in this recruiting period. Our custodial staff here at the Bob, you know, they are a phenomenal group of people who do an unbelievable job 365 days a year. But in recruiting, it is ramped up, and they are terrific. Our faculty, our partners in academics, the staff who meet and counsel the recruits when they come to campus, Tim Morrissey and our academic support team, for the terrific job they do meeting with the prospective student athletes and their parents while they're on campus. Coach Hess and our strength and conditioning team, all the things that they do with their presentations and try to get our young people to understand, you know, that they will be fully developed if they come to the University of Delaware. Kevin Rose and our equipment staff do an unbelievable job. The presentation that they do with the Under Armour gear and then showing the young guys the locker room and the facilities that they'll ultimately use when they become Blue Hens. Athletic trainer Dan Watson, Dr. Reisman, his staff, and Dan's staff, you know, the time and the energy that they use to meet with each individual recruit, each individual recruit's family, and go through the process that the players will go through in their time here to ensure the parents and the players that they'll be looked after is terrific, and they do a great job. The athletic media relations staff, Scott Selheimer, Jimmy Smith, their staffs, who most of them are in the back right now, they do an unbelievable job. They work tirelessly for us, and we're appreciative. We got a lot of partners in recruiting when we bring this number of people to campus. You know, we want to thank Embassy Suites. We want to thank Klondike Kate's, the Green Turtle, Cafe Gelato, UD Motor Pool, who provides buses for us to take the families around. We use the campus buses so they know exactly what it is when they get here. And then the UD Dining Service, who provides a meal for us every time we bring recruits on campus so they get a feel for the food they're going to eat, and they do an unbelievable job providing that experience for us. The National 5 and 10 experience, Brian Hanloff and his staff, the recruits and their families love that stop every recruiting weekend. That is the highlight of what they do on the Main Street tour. So, you know, we're thrilled for them. And then last, but you know, certainly not least, the members of the Delaware football team. One signature of a great program is that the players on your current team are the best recruiters in your program. And my hat's off to the players on our team for the job that they did. You know, they were the ones on the front line talking about the future of Delaware football and everything that goes on. Our coaching staff did a tremendous job, not only with recruiting, but with evaluating the young people. I'm very, very thankful for them and for the support of their families, when the reality of recruiting is we spend far more time with other people's families than we do with our own family, you know, during this period of time. I'm convinced that, you know, not only do we bring the right players to Delaware, we brought the right people. You know, recruiting provides an opportunity to see just how dynamic the University of Delaware is. The signees and their families love the campus, the history and the tradition of the football program, But most of all, they love the people that they meet when they're in the UD community. You know, recruiting is ultimately about relationships, and I feel like our foundation's rock solid with the high school coaches in our recruiting footprint. You know, we'll work tirelessly to continue to sell the great university we have and work towards a goal of having a football program that everybody who loves the University of Delaware is very, very proud of. Again, I'll go through the signees individually. I'll answer any questions that you have about each person, and then we'll move on. I'm going to use the release that you have, and I'll go through it in that order. All right, first up, alphabetically. All right, Riley Angeline. You know, Riley is a listed as an athlete. Riley's a terrific player. You know, very, very dynamic young guy. Really was an interesting recruiting story. Coach Ginn did a great job recruiting him. And, you know, he was in a situation where he had a lot of choices. You know, he could have gone to an American Athletic Conference school. He could have gone to multiple MAC schools. He could have gone to multiple CAA schools. And we're thrilled that he's with us. You know, the probably the best thing I could say about Riley is I'm not 100% sure what he's going to be. I'm just certain he's going to be something, and I think it's going to be something really special. I think he could play multiple places on offense, and I think he could probably play, you know, multiple places on defense before his career's up. So we're thrilled to have him. You know, he played for Mike Matta, who is a terrific coach in Eastern PA and Downingtown East. His mother's a graduate of Delaware, which I would tell you probably is going to help the recruiting process. It certainly did in this case, you know, and we're thrilled to have him. Any questions about Riley?
Yeah, so he's a guy you see playing both offense and defense. Is that kind of like what he did in high school?
Well, he played both ways. I think his skill set is such that, you know, I could see putting him at linebacker and feeling unbelievable about his opportunity to help us win, you know, in his career here. We could put him at tight end, at a move tight end, and kind of like a Ryan Cobb, and I could see him being an unbelievable weapon, you know, not only in the run game but the pass game. I could see him playing tailback like he did in high school, you know, and it's just going to depend on really where he fits and you know, what he naturally becomes. He's a big, long, athletic young guy, and again, he's got a dynamic skill set. I think he's going to be an awesome player here. Anybody else? All right, Charles Bell from Penn Manor High School, linebacker. You know, Charles is a young guy who, you know, I'm really, really excited about. I think, and I'll say this as a generality, I think that the three linebackers we signed in this class are home runs. You know, and you know, again, Charlie is a terrific player, run and hit guy, very, very physical player. When you watch him play, you know, his skill set is such that, you know, he's a terror when he's playing on defense. He's a tremendous tackler, a very physical kid. And then you watch him play on offense, and he's got elusiveness. You know, he can hit the same holes as a running back that he has to hit as a linebacker. And that's something that is a very, very special skill. I think he's going to be a very dynamic player. And again, many, many, many accolades. You know, we're really, really excited that we were able to get him. He was a very heavily recruited young player. And you know, again, we're thrilled that we have him in this class. Any questions about Charles? Malcolm Brown. Malcolm is from Quince Orchard, you know, a popular high school these days at the University of Delaware's football program, you know, with Zach and Travis. You know, Malcolm is a really, really dynamic player. You know, we're, again, thrilled to get him. Much competition. Malcolm had 1A offers, multiple CAA offers. You know, Coach Baker, you know, did a terrific, terrific job developing a relationship with him and his family. You know, he obviously plays at a very competitive school, and you know, he's a dynamic guy. He will help us on special teams. He's a kick returner, punt returner, defensive back. He's got a skill set to be very, very versatile. You know, again, one of the more dynamic kids that I've seen and been a part of recruiting. Certainly a guy that I would have loved to have had at Rutgers, you know, when I was at Rutgers. And on a personal note, a side note, if a set of parents cooks better fish than his parents, I would like to meet them, because it is, I called the mom this morning and I talked to her about, you know, now that he's signed, I'm allowed to legally come down to their house and eat the fish whenever I want. So again, he is a terrific player and a terrific young guy. Well, I think ultimately that'll work itself out. Skill set wise and athletically, he certainly could play corner. He could play safety. He could play wideout. You know, when you watch his film, he's a very dynamic player. You know, he's got great change of direction. He's got great range. He's very physical. He's got great ball skills. You know, so those things translate certainly to being able to play corner. It'll just depend on where he fits. And again, he's a versatile guy. So, you know, he's going to have opportunities that'll be created for himself because of his skill set. You know, he's going to fit a lot of different things for us, and we need more players like that, and we're thrilled to have him.
Was that a tough land, considering his brother plays inside the conference?
Well, his brother's situation's unique. He was at another school, and he's now transferred to Towson, I think, to be closer to home. It was a tough land because he was offered at East Carolina. He probably had five or six MAC offers. Villanova offered him. You know, it was a tough land because of the competition that you're dealing with in that situation. But he loved it here. You know, he had a great experience here. We found, and something that I thought was very interesting, when we looked at the guys who were committed to us and who were very, very heavily recruited, one of our single greatest advantages that we had when we signed these guys today was the fact that they had come and seen us play live this year. You know, when these kids come to Delaware Stadium and this place is rocking, the environment's electric and it draws the players. You know, so our ability to get young guys here to these games as we're in the recruiting process, it really paid an awful lot of dividends in terms of this class. Anything else on Malcolm? All right, Trey Brown. Trey's a wide receiver. You know, we had the opportunity with Trey. He's from Milton Hershey High School, and we had the opportunity to see him live at a camp on another campus, and just were struck by the fact that he was such a big, graceful, athletic young guy, you know, moving around, and we saw him in terms of his ability to play either outside receiver or slot receiver. Again, very versatile player, athletic guy, plays basketball, multi-sport guy. You'll see a common theme across these young people. You know, we signed an awful lot of captains. We signed an awful lot of guys who were champions. We signed an awful lot of guys, you know, who did an awful lot of really, really good things. And that's what we're looking for. We're looking for winning in the DNA. We're looking for leadership in their DNA. And I think we signed an awful lot of that with this class. You know, he's a very athletic young guy. You know, and he's going to be able to go out and I think line up and be a competitive player as a young player. With our ability and our desire to play the best guys and as many guys as we can on special teams, you know, I think this young guy will have a chance with his length and his ability to move around. He'll have a chance to go out and compete, you know, for a spot, even if it's not initially at receiver, because of the depth and the ability level that we have at that position, you know, today. Any questions on Trey? Well, part of the situation this year with recruiting, and one of the reasons the class has the size that it does and it's significant like it is we're trying to address some roster imbalances. So in other words, we had to sign a certain number of players at certain positions, even if you look at our roster today and say, well, I'm not certain there's a need there, because the amount of players that will leave next year at that position will be significant. You look at linebacker, for instance, we're going to lose four guys. We had eight, which is a good number, but we're going to lose four. And when you have the number of transfer players that we have in our program right now, when those transfers come into your program, they just kind of drop in different places and then they exit. And if they're here for 2 years, when they leave, that's a hole. There isn't a young player that was recruited that will fill that hole, that will develop and be able to step in and play. So what we're trying to do is address our immediate needs, which are significant, and then we're trying to address what future, you know, potential holes we may have. So we've signed in a couple additional kids this year to try to be a little bit forward thinking in terms of what we're going to lose in the future. You know, and we'll get the running back. I'll use that as an example. You know, we have two running backs on our roster, two scholarship running backs. That's it. You know, you'd like to have five. And we don't have any scholarship running backs that are somewhere else on the roster at linebacker or any of those places. So we felt like it was necessary to bring in a guy and a couple guys to play that position. So that's why you'll see a couple of different positions with that seem heavy compared to what the roster is.
You speak of roster balances. Other than linebackers and running backs, who else were you looking for to fill holes?
Well, you look at the scholarship allotment at quarterback. You know, we have a true freshman and then 2 5th-year seniors. You know, so we have 3 years worth of recruiting classes where there are no players. You know, so that's something that we had to address and a situation that we looked at. Running back would be similar. We have a redshirt sophomore and a true sophomore, and we have no third-year player, no fourth-year player, or no fifth-year player at running back. Running back was another one. Now, thankfully, Justin Burns has made the decision, even though he's graduating, that he's going to come back and play his fifth year, which certainly was not necessarily in the cards. So, you know, we got a little bit of a bonus there, but we're still top heavy. You know, at the end of this season, at the end of this fall in December, you know, ultimately we'll have 2 quarterbacks leaving and really 2 left on scholarship. So we're going to have to, again, address that, you know, in the future. Offensive line, we certainly have fewer scholarship, you know, numbers allocated there than we would like. We've tried to address that on the front end, and that's such a developmental, you know, position. You really always like to have more rather than less. We're in a situation today where we have less. And then in the secondary, you know, we needed to bring in a couple of young players, you know, again, to complement a couple of the young players that came in last year, because we went 3 full recruiting cycles without signing a high school corner. So we were a little bit short in terms of that. We had taken transfers here in the past in those spots, and those guys are now going to kind of rotate out when they're done. You know, we needed to make sure that we had the appropriate number of people. Anything else with those guys? All right, next, Mario Farinella. Mario's an offensive lineman from Bergen Catholic, certainly a tradition-rich program. Nunzio Campanelli is a friend, somebody who I trust. And, you know, when we talked about this young guy, he said all the things that we wanted to hear: tough, violent, physical, mentality, those types of things. He's an inside player. He's got terrific movement. He's tough. He's physical. You know, when we watched him, we had him live at another camp. We loved him, you know, and then when you get around the guy and you meet him, he's got a little bit of personality. He's got a little bit of pizzazz to him, which you like, you know, and he's tough. We need to bring that element of toughness into this program every day, whether it's the coaches, the current players, the recruits. You know, we need to create an environment where we have more of a chip on our shoulder as a program, and I think Mario is going to help us do that. And again, few guys up in New Jersey do I hold in higher regard than Nuns. I mean, he's done a great job there, and he's certainly coached an awful lot of really, really talented players. And, you know, he puts his stamp of approval on this guy, and you know, we're really, really excited to have him.
Have you got kids from this program before, like at other schools?
At other schools, yeah. You know, and again, I mean, he is longtime Don Bosco. Ended up going over and being the head coach there. His brother was a GA at Rutgers while I was there. Now he's the tight end coach at Rutgers. You know, so I'm very familiar with them. I actually saw him. I was at the Northeast Coaches Clinic last Thursday or Friday, whatever day it was, in New Jersey. And, you know, I got a chance to run into him. And you know, he couldn't have been more excited about, you know, Mario coming down. And you know, he was really, really excited about Delaware football and the direction we're going. So it was a lot of fun to have that conversation. Yeah, I think it probably helps more the knowledge of the area than Rutgers. I've been a long time recruiting that state, a long time, you know, being involved with those coaches and speaking at clinics, and a lot of 7 years at Hofstra, and when I was at North Carolina, I recruited the Northeast, and, you know, so I've got a lot of familiarity with a lot of the guys who coach in that area. I don't know that my Rutgers experience was that dramatic, although I did work with his brother you know, I think the world of him. I think he's a really good coach, and you know, I'm excited that he loves Mario. All right, Troy Gallen. Troy's at Malvern Prep. Played for Kevin Pellegrini. All I hear about is Gamp Pellegrini, who's a legendary high school coach and again, a Delaware player. Troy's another team captain. An interesting stat for Troy is he was in our summer camp situation last year, getting in here a little bit late, but having the ability to ramp it up. We had about 700 kids, give or take, Jerry would know, in terms of what we had at the camp. And, Troy was the third fastest player of all the campers. This guy can really, really run. He's going to add an element to our team that is much needed. And he's a pretty dynamic player with the ball in his hands, a versatile player. He plays running back, he plays receiver, he's a kick returner. He's got a lot of different skill sets and he can make plays when the ball's in his hand and he's going to have a interesting opportunity from a role standpoint. It's interesting. I'm thinking about Delaware football. I'm watching the Super Bowl, and you watch a guy like Percy Harvin come in and play six, seven, eight plays, and all of a sudden, bang, he's got a huge impact in the game. And really, he's not doing anything in terms of being a receiver. He's catching the ball, he's running back a kick, he's getting the ball handed to him, and he's really having a dynamic effect on the game. And I think when you look at that, that's speed. That's the ability to run faster than most of the other players. In that game, a lot of other fast players. I think this guy at this level is going to have, an impact with his speed and his ability to make plays with the ball. So we're thrilled to have him, and again, very, very excited about, the opportunity that he's going to have here to compete and play early. Any questions on Troy? All right, Andrew Grau. Andrew's a tight end and a defensive end, one of Delaware's own. We're thrilled to be able to sign two players from Delaware. He played down at Cape Henlopen, played for Coach Collick, who I know a lot of you guys know. I think the world of Coach Collick. I think he's a terrific person, a terrific coach, and went down there in the spring and visited with him. And he put his stamp on this guy. He said, Coach, this is the guy. You got to make sure that you see him and look at him. We developed a relationship. We got him up to camp, worked him out in camp, really loved him. Just a raw, big-boned kid who could move. And we're really, really, really excited about his prospects. Had an unfortunate injury during his senior year, so he missed most of his senior year. But again, we felt like, he's a guy that is going to be able to help us win down the road. We were going to stick with him and we're really, really excited to sign him. Disappointed for him that he missed most of his senior year. It was off to a good start, and then disappointed, obviously, that he's not able to play basketball and do some of the things in your senior year that you'd love each guy to have an opportunity to do. But we really think very, very highly of him. We're going to bring him in here, make sure he's healthy, and then we're going to give him, an opportunity to play in the home state, which everybody should be excited about.
Why do you like him on the offensive side?
Well, I think that's where you start him. Yeah. I think when we watched him, his skill set presented a little bit more to us on that side of the ball. Again, we're in a situation at tight end where realistically we had to bring in some people. We're going to lose because of our transfer situation at that position. We lose Malcolm Bush after this season, and he was a spot player for us, and then we'll lose Boyle and Cobb in that combination, and so you end up with Rodriguez, and you got to make sure that you got what you need. So we had to bring in a number of tight ends to do what we do offensively. You need bodies there. You need to be able to be multiple, and we want big athletic guys who can run and who have position flexibility. Because the reality is, if you're a really big, physical, athletic kid and you can't be this, you likely can be that. And I know I made a joke at some point last year, and I wasn't kidding, but you see Nick Boyle, you want to collect Nick Boyle. You just want him to have a different name. And this ultimately is somebody we think will have that type of skill set. And whether it's a defensive end when he's 20 years old or a couple of these guys we're going to be talking about, we're counting on them being really, really good 20-year-olds, really good players in the last 3 years of their career, and they're developmental. And we're going to really coach them hard and get them big and get them strong and get them tough. And then we're going to hope that we get an awful lot of return on that investment.
What was the injury that kept him out?
Yeah. ask Kevin. Text Kevin and Sochi. Tell them I don't talk. I'm not going to talk about injuries of guys who are here. I'm not going to talk about injuries of guys before they get here. But that's a great question. You know.
Well, let me ask you.
Ooh. All right. Rephrase.
Before his senior year, was he considered someone, you know, who could be like a D1 prospect? I mean, was he?
If you ask me my opinion, I felt like he had that skill set, that ability level. Would he have been? It wouldn't be fair for me to say that. I'm not going to – I don't want to make it something it isn't. He had a tremendous amount of interest from teams in our league. He had a tremendous amount of interest from other people just because of, he's a big, rangy kid who can move, run around. He had a lot of experience playing. He's a multi-sport athlete. You know, those things are attractive to other people. But he got hurt early in the year. And you know, again, for us – you know, he was what we felt like we wanted to play with. He's somebody we felt like would be a great player to develop. And, again, we're thrilled we have him. And now we're just looking to make sure he gets healthy, take care of his rehab, and do the things he needs to do. We'll bring him in here and we'll get him on and get him going. Good on Andrew? All right. Maurice Harley. Again, a secondary player, probably likely a safety from St. John's College High School. You know, really, really physical player. When you watch Maurice's tape, you know, you see a run and hit violent player. You really like the way he plays. He's got a great presence about him. He played a couple games, you know, that we watched on tape where he's playing at the University of Maryland. It's great film. You know, he plays fast. He plays violent. He's a very good tackler. A very, very strong kid when he plays the game of football. You know, regardless of what he lifts or doesn't lift, you know, when he strikes you, he's going to knock you back. He runs to the ball. He's a fearless competitor, really, really enjoyed, again, watching him play. There's certain styles, there's certain types of players when you turn the tape on that appeal to you, that jump out to you. And Maurice was somebody who jumped out at me, you know, almost immediately when I watched him. In a couple of those game tapes that I watched. So we were thrilled to get him. And he's a guy who makes plays in the back end in the passing game. He sacks the quarterback. He turns the ball over. You know, all those things, all those different things that you're looking for in defensive players, he's got all those skill sets. So we're thrilled. And, again, Henry Baker did a terrific job, you know, recruiting him. And he's a tough guy to get. Now, you watch him on tape, you're going to see a pretty dynamic football player. Any questions on Maurice? Anthony Jackson, linebacker from Suitland High School, which is a storied program in the state of Maryland. Played for Ed Shields. He's a team captain. He was selected to play in the Big 33 game, which is a very, very prestigious game. I'm sure you guys are aware of that. He came here early on and camped here. And watching him move, watching his skill set, being able to work with him, we really felt good about him. He's a guy that we offered early. We felt very, very strongly that he would be somebody that we'd want to coach. He was very heavily recruited in our league and above our league, had an awful lot of options. His relationship with Coach Bake and our ability to get him early and recruit him probably a little bit differently than some other people had the opportunity to do. Really helped us, and he committed to us early, and because I think he's a young guy of character, he hung in there. You know, he was getting assaulted here at the end, and he hung with us and really did a terrific job. I'm proud of him. I'm proud of his mom, for standing tall and keeping the commitment. And again, we're really, really excited about him. Again, he's part of that linebacker trio that I think is going to be very, very dynamic. I think those three players are going to put their mark on Delaware football, in my opinion. Any questions on Anthony?
Well, obviously the defense, you felt like something you guys kind of have to address it with this recruiting class.
Well, yes and no. I mean, certainly we have to be better on defense. But again, I would tell you this. I think if you look at what we did offensively this past season, we did it with a group of players who didn't perform very well the year before. We were one of the bottom 20 offenses in the country in 2012. And what we brought back was a group of players who had a lot of experience, albeit not a lot of great experience, but a lot of experience, practical, functional playing time. And they've been in those situations. And I think what you saw was a group of players who, because of that, were able to perform better. And then once you perform well, now you start to gain confidence. And you know, confidence is what ultimately makes you produce and be a good player. I think the guys that we have back on defense, and there's a slew of them, you know, now have a lot of the same situation. They're in the same situation that the offensive kids were in. They played a lot of football. You know, a lot of it wasn't a great result. You know, and what they're going to do now is they have a frame of reference, and they have the ability to now draw from that and get better. I expect that we'll have the type of you know, rebound defensively that we had offensively this year. You know, this year on defense, we were similar. We didn't have a lot of guys who played a lot of football. You know, Zach Kerr had played a lot of football. Zach Kerr, he played well. You know, some of the other guys who played a lot had played well. You know, the back end kids on defense, they hadn't played any football. You know, and again, at times it looked like it. And we got to do a better job coaching, and we got to do a better job of managing our own issues. But, you know, I think that we'll see a pretty good blip, you know, to the positive on defense. And I think adding players of Anthony's caliber and these other players' caliber will only help. You know, again, it's a talent-driven deal. You know, and you go out and you get really good players, and you got a lot better chance to play really good football. Good on Anthony? All right, Quay Jefferson. Quay's from St. Joe's Regional, which is a dominant program in North Jersey. Played for Tony Karsich, who's a legend up there. Recently retired, retired a couple weeks ago, but did an unbelievable job. I'm not sure how familiar you are with Quay and his situation. You know, he has one of the more dynamic personal stories that I've been involved with since I've been in coaching. You know, his mother is ill. He's taken care of his mother for the better part of the last 4 years. And I would tell you to Google him, read up on the story, and take a look at some of the videos that were done with him, whether it's on ESPN or Fox or different things like that, and you'll see a young guy who has unbelievable character and unbelievable resolve, and how he handled the situation with his mom. I mean, it was phenomenal, and to be involved with a young guy like that, you know, and feel like, hey, this is somebody we could bring into our program. We were very, very excited to be able to do it. And he's an outstanding football player. You know, very versatile guy. I think he scored 4, maybe 5 touchdowns in the state championship game. You know, very productive player. Tony's coached an awful lot of good players at St. Joe's Regional through the years. And he loves this kid. This guy had a lot of options. And again, he was adamant that he wanted to stay in the time frame that he would be able to get home and see mom and take care of any potential issues. And again, we've got a very, very good football player in Quay, but I would tell you we've got a better person, and we're really, really excited that he's part of the Delaware football family.
Do you like that character, you know, adding that to your team?
Yeah, I think it's unique. Again, if Quay had a quote-unquote normal family life, we would have taken Quay. Quay's a really good player. The dynamic of what he had to do and how he had to do it and his struggles and you know, watching him do all these things and achieving what he achieved, again, it's pretty special. You know, there's no woe is me, there's no sucking your thumb. You know, he put his head down, he went to work. He got up at 5 o'clock in the morning so he could take care of his mother. You know, he'd come home right after school, you know, so he could make sure that you know, he did the things that he needed to do. So again, we're very, very excited to have him, and again, we're proud of what he's done, as a lot of people are, and the support system that he had at St. Joe's was second to none. You know, a lot of people caring and a lot of people making sure that you know, again, this young guy had a chance to be successful, and you know, they're going to turn him over to us, and we can't wait to get our hands on him. Anything else on Quay? Thomas Jefferson, the president. Thomas is a terrific, terrific player from Passaic Tech, obviously home of the recent Super Bowl playing safety, Mike Adams. You know, Thomas is a terrific player. He's a big, explosive running back, you know, and really, really a dynamic young guy. You know, somebody that we were interested in for a long time, got really, really active in recruiting him in December and January. You know, got into the home, got into the school, met with the coach, And you know, really, really, we're sold on the young guy and his ability. He's a, you know, again, he's a dynamic player. He's a track guy, fast, big. You know, probably I would give him, he'll be on the all-voice team when he gets here. You have to hear him talk. It'd be worth calling him and doing an interview just to listen to it. He's got an awesome voice, very deep. You know, had a chance to go to a MAC school, was offered and on a visit on a MAC campus this past weekend, and you know, came home and made the decision that Delaware football was where he wanted to be, and that's the type of guy we want to recruit. You know, we feel like within our footprint, within 5 hours of this campus, there shouldn't be a MAC school who can beat us in recruiting. You know, and we're going to go head to head with those people. We're going to go head to head with the CAA teams, and you know, we're going to slug it out. And in my opinion, if we do the job that we're capable of and the job that we should do, you know, we should win more than we don't. And you know, this is a great case of you know, being in a situation where, you know, we're going to get a young guy who physically may have a chance to help us, and certainly with his skill set. You know, he'll be very versatile. You know, he'll be able to play on special teams. He'll be able to run and hit. You know, he's a weapon when he's got the ball in his hands when he's running it. He's a physical runner. You know, so, I mean, we're thrilled. And again, very, very excited because like many of these young guys, they chose Delaware. You know, they want to be at Delaware. And that's so important to me, so important to the people in this program. And you know, again, we're thrilled to have him, thrilled to have his family, and again, we're excited about it. And again, with our depth at running back, you know, we're certainly going to look at you know, those guys being able to compete to play, because our philosophy won't change. We're going to play three running backs, same as we did last year. Any questions on Thomas? All right, James Krakowski. James is from Oceanside High School in Long Island, New York. Played for Rob Blount. You know, there's a long-standing relationship I have with the former coach at Oceanside, a guy named Frank Luisi, who was there forever, Jay Fiedler's coach when he was there prior to going to Dartmouth in the NFL. We saw James compete at a camp, loved him, you know, and started to recruit him and felt like we weren't 100% sure. You know, he had some offers at some 1A schools and you know, he was a guy who was fascinated with Delaware. He loved the place. Once he came down and saw the campus, no, he's going good. He was very, very interested in what we were doing, how we were doing it. He's a unbelievably strong student. You know, he's a terrific, terrific academic guy and a guy we feel like is going to be a bookend tackle for us for a long time. You know, and very, very big. One of the bigger beards I've ever seen on a high school player. But he is a terrific player and a great developmental guy for this program, because you don't find guys that are that big and move like he moves and competes like he competes on tape. And you know, we're thrilled to have him. Anything on James? All right, John Nassib, again, from Malvern Prep. Same situation with Coach Pellegrini and a team captain. His dad played here. His brother's one of the quarterbacks for the New York Giants, played at Syracuse. You know, this is a young guy who we saw, again, we saw him live on another campus at a camp. And you know, I absolutely loved him. I loved the way he moved. I loved the way he got around in the camp. He really did a great job, you know, from a standpoint of being able to transition from an offensive drill to a defensive drill. And we're going to start him on defense. At defensive end, and let it see where it happens. I don't know what he'll end up being. You know, he may not shave for another 18 months. You know, and he could be a enormous, enormous human being when it's all said and done. So an awful lot of things with him that will be projections. But he had great movement, and when you watch the tape and you watch him play, he had an unbelievable knack to be around the ball, to get the ball. I think he had 6 interceptions. You know, as a defensive end, you know, there were some really, really dynamic things that jumped off film at you. And then when you meet the guy and you get to know him, you know, you're so certain he's the right person. You're so certain he's the right kid that you just feel great about it. And again, I think he's going to be a terrific player here. You know, the family loves the place, and it's a football family. You know, those are great kids to have in your program. And again, we're really, really excited to have John. Any questions about John? All right. Bilal Nichols. Bilal's from Hodgkin. Played for Coach Moffitt. I recruited Bilal and primarily because he's in the state of Delaware, and that's where I recruit. He is a terrific young player, a terrific person. First team all state, big, versatile, athletic body. I think that'll be a trend you see across the class. We're collecting body types. We're going to collect skill sets that we feel are going to give us the best chance going forward to really, really play physical and fast football. From a student standpoint, he's a terrific guy in the classroom. Very, very competitive basketball player. When you go watch him play, he committed to us a while back and really never looked back. Terrific family situation. I was in the home, many, many times. And just a dynamic young guy. I had a relationship with Coach Moffitt. The twins, the Merrill twins, played at Rutgers, were terrific players there. It was an interesting frame of reference for me to hear Coach Moffitt compare and contrast, Bilal and the knowledge that I had about those kids. It was very, very enjoyable, but great to have a young guy from a championship program in state who has a unlimited, potential and a high ceiling. And I think ultimately he'll help us a lot of places. And again, we're really excited. We're going to start him on defense and see if we can't cut him loose.
To be able to keep guys like that in state, I mean, how important is that?
Well, I think it's important. It's a function of really a couple things. We're going to recruit the state as hard as we can. And it starts with me. I'm going to make the same pledge I made last year. I'll be in every single school that plays football in the state of Delaware. In the spring, April to the end of May. I'm going to evaluate the players that are in this state, and we're going to try and take the guys that we feel can help us win championships. We're not going to take somebody because they're from Delaware. We're going to go and we're going to evaluate and we're going to look at, and there were a number of players that are in the state that were, I mean, they're close. We felt really, really strongly about a lot of the guys that we signed. A kid or two from Delaware were either the next guy or second next guy in terms of where they might have fell on the board. So I thought it was a great year. You look at the dynamic players that are going, whether you got the young guys from Middletown, who are going multiple places, Louisiana, there's some really good players that played in the state. I think it's a testament to where Delaware football is going. I traveled down to the All-State Banquet, a week, 10 days ago, and just thoroughly impressed with the young people, what the quality of student they're putting out, the quality of player that they're putting out. I feel like we can go out and have a really good year recruiting Delaware every year. I love the two players we have from Delaware this year. I think it's a great year, and whether it's four players or maybe it's one player one year. But that's how we're going to approach it. We're going to know the state. We're going to be in every school. We're going to do our due diligence. And then we're going to look at it from a player perspective of, can this young guy help us in the classroom, in the community, and can he help us win championships? If the answer is yes, we're going to recruit him as hard as we possibly can. Anything else on Bilal? Jethro Pepe. Jethro is a young guy from St. Joe's in Colonia, New Jersey, which is mid-state. He is a pure projection. He's a guy who we had at camp, big, big athletic guy, and not filled out, not fully developed, but a guy who can really move and run and change direction and do a lot of those things that are really, really important. We're bringing him in as an offensive tackle. And he played a lot of tight end. He played a little bit of tackle. He played defensive end, versatile guy, athletic guy. And somebody that we feel is an unbelievable projection, in terms of where we think he'll end up in a couple of years. Another player that we would anticipate being a really, really good 20-year-old football player. You know, great family. You know, we had to, with the shakeup at some of the Division I schools, some of the staff members ended up at different places, and, you know, he had a chance to go out and take a MAC opportunity this past week and chose not to, and again, stayed committed, didn't take the visit. And, you know, again, we're thrilled that we're signing that caliber of person, you know, because it certainly takes some character and you know, some resolve to make sure that you made the right decision and that you're not tempted to go and you know, partake in some of the foolishness. Anything on Jethro? All right, Jake Powell. You know, Jake's a young guy who's got a, as you can tell by the length of his bio, he's got a lot of history here at Delaware, family history. Brother plays baseball. Dad played here, was, I believe, a captain on the baseball team and played football for a couple years from a terrific school in South Jersey, Cherokee. P.J. Meehan is a terrific coach, and Jake came to camp. And again, we loved him. You know, we loved the body type. Tall, he's a rangy guy. He's going to be a very, very big human being. He's probably 230 pounds now. Again, he's a guy who has gone out and done a terrific job in everything he's done. Been a captain in football, been a captain in basketball. He's a terrific student and really a versatile player. We think, you know, again, his skill set right now is, you know, he's a big, gigantic receiver who plays tight end. He's got great hands, great ball skills, great movement ability. He can shake free, get open. You know, he can be a mismatch in a stand-up type of slot position on a linebacker. But again, we're looking to see where he ends up. You know, I think he had 3 or 4 sacks in the championship game in Jersey, you know, playing defensive end. So he plays both ways. He's a very productive player. You know, big body, versatile. Those were things that you know, drew us to him. And again, then you could talk about the bloodlines and you talk about the love that those folks have for Delaware football. You know, we're thrilled that we have him. I've known his dad for a long time and his mom for a long time. Again, we're thrilled that he's in the football family. You know, we feel like he's going to be a dynamic player for us. You know, we'll see how it shakes out. We'll see what he does early on. Because you know he has the ability to go catch the ball and be a receiving threat. Any questions on Jake? All right, Frankie Rago, our kicker. All right, he is again a young guy we recruited from Central Jersey. You know, Coach Fitzsimmons evaluated him and did a terrific job. He's mad at me because I didn't call him Fitz. You know, he is a guy that we're going to count on to come in and compete to be our kicker. You know, again, it's a unique situation that we came into. You know, you'd love to have a scholarship kicker on the back end of his career. You would have loved to have had a walk-on kicker who you brought in with the thought that he would be the next kicker. And you'd always love to give the kicker that is in your program a scholarship because you recruited him for that purpose. You know, we didn't have that luxury right now. We're in a situation where, you know, we felt like we had to bring a guy in you know, put him in a competitive situation to come in and earn the job. So, you know, that's really what he's up against. You know, he did a nice job, you know, from a standpoint of being able to kick field goals, extra points, be a kickoff guy, again, a true specialist. You know, he's going to come in and he's going to battle to be our kicker. You know, we're hopeful that he can do it. We've got a couple guys in the program who are going to compete with him. You know, they have 6-7 months to put themselves in a position where they can do it. You know, but he was a guy we felt very strongly about, and we felt like he was going to give us a chance to have a competitive guy going into next season. So we're thrilled that Frank chose to come to Delaware. And again, you know, we're hoping he comes and knocks it through the pipes here, you know, come August. Anything on Frank? Well, I mean, it's like anything with kicking. I mean, if he makes his kicks, he'll be a great replacement. You know, if he doesn't, then not so much. You know, you have to be in that world that they live in. You know, it's tough. You know, you got to make the kicks. You know, and you have to see how he's going to react to pressure. We're going to have to put him under pressure, put him in situations. You know, but we think he's got the skill set. We think he's got the leg strength. You know, we think he's got the demeanor that you need to come in and be in that spot. You know, will we have the luxury that we had with Sean for this season and that they've had here for a number of years? I don't think so. I think that comes with experience and confidence and all the things that Sean had that made him such a good kicker. We're hoping that Frank can be Sean someday, I guess would be the way I would put it. Anything else on Frank? All right, Dante Raymond, the third of three of the linebacker group from Rahway High School, played for Coach Mobley. You know, Dante's a dynamic player, very, very physical, fast twitch, you know, violent run and hit player. You know, he is a guy who can rush the passer successfully. He can play coverage. He can match up and run with people. You know, he's a run stopper. Very, very good tackler. One of the things that I'm really, really excited about in this collective group at linebacker is they're all really, really fierce tacklers. That, you know, they're going to go get you and be violent. And, you know, he certainly fits that bill. You know, he had a very unique recruiting situation. You know, before Coach O'Brien left Penn State offered him. You know, and you know, I always felt that Dante would come to Delaware. You know, through the transition and everything that happened, you know, all he did was reaffirm his commitment to wanting to be a Blue Hen and wanting to be a part of Delaware football. And, you know, of all the guys I talked to after they signed this morning, you know, I would tell you that Dante was happy and relieved, you know, and just so excited to be part of our football family. And we're thrilled to have him. You know, we got great relationships in Rahway. The Garay brothers for years played at BC and Hofstra, and you know, we got a lot of close ties in that community and with people up there. Again, this guy's a very, very dynamic player, and you know, we think we got an absolute steal with him, so we're thrilled to have him. Anything on Dante? Brian Reed from Mount Sinai out on Long Island. Again, another team captain, offensive lineman, interior type player, center guard type player. Again, very, very smart, young guy, very explosive. Another player that camped at Delaware. You know, we had our hands on him. We worked with him. We were able to see exactly what his skill set was. We were able to put him in positions to make sure that we believed he had everything we wanted in terms of, you know, being able to go out and do what we're going to do offensively. He's got great movement, great skill set from a standpoint of strength and explosion. You know, we're thrilled that he's here and great family, you know, and the opportunity that he had, he committed to us early and you know, had some other offers and some other opportunities and was steadfast and was, again, wanting to do anything he could do to help us recruit, wanted to be a part of it. And, you know, those guys, especially, you know, when you get a core group of offensive linemen like we have, you know, you're really, really excited about it, because when that group ultimately can be the soul of your football team. And, you know, he really is a special young guy and multiple-year starter and, again, very, very aggressive physical kid. So we're thrilled that we have him. Any questions on Brian? All right, Joe Walker. Joe is our quarterback, played at Martin Luther King High School. For Ed Dunn, he's a team captain. You know, Joe is a highly decorated player. You know, he is the person that we targeted early on. He's the person that we felt was the guy that we wanted to come play football at the University of Delaware at quarterback. He was probably, you know, a 10 or 12 offer player, probably had five or six MAC offers, was at the you know, took an official visit to a MAC school this past weekend with an offer. Came home and still felt like the University of Delaware was where he wanted to be. His family was you know, committed to us. He was committed to us. Again, when you get in those situations and you're recruiting against bowl teams and teams that have had great success and you're able still to have the type of product that we have here at the University of Delaware, and that guy comes back and says, hey, I want to be a Blue Hen. You know, it juices you up. It makes you feel like, hey, you're at the right place, and you know, we got a chance to do this. You know, again, dynamic player. You can see all the statistics. I mean, he's got the most touchdowns ever in the public league combined from that standpoint. Played in the Chesapeake Bowl, got rave reviews in the All-Star game he played in. Again, he is a across-the-board dynamic player. and we are thrilled that he chose to come to Delaware. You know, so we're very, very excited about Joe and the fact that we were able to add him to our class. If you want to call him a dual threat, I'll agree. He can run and he can throw. So, is Trent a dual threat? All right, I think Trent's a dual threat. So, yeah, Joe, I mean, again, when you watch his tape, you watch this young guy, I mean, he is a dynamic player. And I would tell you he's a dynamic player with the ball in his hand, period. Whether he throws it or runs it, you know, he's a playmaker. And he's done a great job. So we had him live. I had him live at a camp, worked with him in the summer, and felt very, very strongly that he was going to be the guy we wanted to coach.
Do you find there's been any backlash based on the old staff used to do at the recruitment quarterback position since every year it seemed like a new transfer was going to come in based on what they used to do? The spine point of recruiting quarterback, is that extra convincing or anything like that?
Well, I think recruiting's about relationships. I think philosophically, what I tell everybody is what our philosophy is, that we want to build this from the ground up. We want to recruit and develop high school players. That's how I think you should build a football program like the University of Delaware. That's how we're going to try to do it. But I've told every single guy and family that we've recruited, that doesn't mean we're not going to take a transfer. You know, we will likely take transfers this season. You know, so, you know, there's a fine line to say, you know, we're going to try and do it. We're going to try and recruit certain positions and you know, fill certain needs from a high school perspective. But at the same time, there's holes in our roster that exist today that we likely need to fill those with a transfer if we can get the right combination of player and kid. You know, and again, I don't want to bring a guy here who is the wrong person. I don't have interest in the guy who has been dismissed from a school because he's failed multiple drug tests, or you know, he's been arrested for this or arrested for that. Or again, that's not the environment that I believe we should create at Delaware. It doesn't have anything to do with anybody else or how anybody else does it or what's been done in the past. This is a philosophical decision that has been made by me, you know, and that's how we're going to do it. You know, but I can tell you right now, I'm actively recruiting a couple of transfers. I won't go into who, but I'm recruiting them. You know, and we likely will take two or three, you know, in this class. If we can match the person and the player, then you know, we feel good about it and it's going to help us win. That's something that we'll do.
You said that was somebody that you saw early to identify somebody you want. What was the first thing that stood out about him? It made him a guy you come to. So significant.
I mean, it'll sound ridiculous, but I heard, you know, I was watching players throw the ball at the camp and, you know, all of a sudden I just hear a ball whistling and, you know, I kind of turned around and you saw it jumping out of his hand and, you know, he was a skinny, skinny guy, you know, but he could really unload the ball and whether it's a fair analogy or not a fair analogy, you know, I watched him throw two or three passes and in my mind, he was Rocky Butler. A better version of Rocky Butler. Don't tell Rocky. You know, bigger, faster. You know, I don't know that anybody has a better arm than The Rock, but similar arm, great arm talent, very, very accurate, which is, for a young player at quarterback, it's very rare where you find a kid who's got terrific arm strength and a lot of arm talent and unique accuracy. And he had both of those things. We're very fortunate to get him. I wouldn't have given us a terrific chance walking out of that camp because I would have thought that you know, he likely would have been recruited up. And again, I mean, he had 15, 16 offers, don't get me wrong. But, you know, he was a guy who came and, you know, he loved Delaware. He loved what we were all about. Sean Devine did an unbelievable job recruiting him, did an unbelievable job developing a relationship with his family. And, you know, he knows him cold. You know, I was in the house three or four times. He was a you know, key cog to what we're trying to do. And again, we're thrilled that we got him. Sit on Joe. All right, Brandon Whaley. Brandon's from Battlefield High School in Virginia. Again, another team captain. Brandon's an on the ball tight end. He's a big physical guy. who, you know, I think can be a receiving threat, but he's got a physical presence to him. He's an aggressive kid, a very, very good blocker. You know, we anticipate him being a on the ball, you know, downhill, point of attack, run blocking type player to start. You know, the guys that are going to have a unique situation in this pool of kids that we just recruited, the tight ends are going to be really, really fortunate. You know, they're going to go into a room when they get here with a young guy who is having a you know, probably will have a historic career at Delaware. He's got an absolutely unmatched work ethic. He's smart. He's productive. You know, so these guys are going to be mentored by a player who is, you know, a phenomenal role model in the classroom, in the community, and then again on the field. So it's a unique opportunity for the tight ends that we're bringing in. You know, those guys should be, you know, accelerated because of who they're surrounded by. Those guys should have a window to, hey, this is how you become successful because of Nick Boyle and you know, the type of player he is. And again, we're thrilled that we have him in the room and you know, we're going to use him. He'll be like an assistant coach / player, you know, because he's going to work with those guys as much as we do, because peer accountability and those things are critical to success as your program grows. Anything else, Brandon? All right, Kareem Williams, last because alphabetically he's last. Young guy from Parkland High School in Pennsylvania. Great program, you know, terrific deal. Team captain. Kareem's a brother of Andre Williams, who was the starting tailback at Boston College and a Heisman Trophy finalist, All-American, might be the all-time leading rusher in Boston College history. You know, so there was some frame of reference from that standpoint. You know, just a dynamic player and runner. So we were thrilled when we were able to get involved with him. Again, he had an opportunity to take another scholarship and waited for us to have the ability to feel like we could offer him the scholarship. And when we did, he took it. And you know, his enthusiasm, his energy on the phone when I was talking to him this morning was you know, it was unbelievable. It was contagious. You know, I love his brother, you know, and he was a warrior, you know, when he was playing at BC, and certainly had a great year. And this guy's going to come up and I think he's going to have a lot of the same attributes. Not quite as big, but he's probably faster. Although, you know, Dre will tell you he isn't, you know, he's got good speed and you know, he's really done a terrific job, had an enormous yards per carry, you know, and was very, very productive. So we were thrilled to be able to add him to the class and you know, Coach Lucas did a terrific job in, you know, from a recruiting standpoint of, you know, making sure we were on point and we were involved. And then, you know, we had a chance to add a really good player in January. And, you know, sometimes that's hard to do. But again, our situation at running back is such that, you know, we needed to do it. You know, we have to add to the pool at that position. And it's going to be a very competitive, you know, camp situation, you know, because we're going to have four scholarship players and we want to play three guys. So, you know, we'll see how it works out and you know, how it sorts out. But he's a talented young guy that we're really excited about and looking forward to having him in our program. Any questions?
You're a long way from this, but is it fair to say in this class, the running backs, linebackers, and these guys that can, special teams guys, specialists, have the best chance to play right away?
Well, I mean, I think that's fair to say probably in every class. I mean, I think, again, the farther away you get from the ball, the easier it is to play as a young player. You know, when you're an 18-year-old kid, you haven't shaved yet. You know, you're not hardened. You know, it's hard to play against a 22-year-old, 23-year-old in some cases guy. You know, imagine yourself at 18 years old, you know, lining up at right guard and Zach Kerr lines up over top of you. You know, it's a little bit different than you know, a corner lining up over top of you. And again, I coached the perimeter on offense for a long time. I mean, you know, there's times out there at any level, it's not much more than a pillow fight, you know, so it's much more athletic, you know, in terms of mentality. If you're a confident player, if you can run and you're confident in terms of your ability to take a hit and your ability to go hit somebody, I don't think it's as hard as people think to be able to play on the perimeter, you know, but inside on defense, on the D-line, on the O-line, you know, again, it's a physical, violent game in there. I mean, you know, you're going to be a little bit of a different guy if you're able to come in and play early there. But I love our skill players. I think they're versatile. I think they're dynamic. And again, a lot of people all over the country are going to love the class they signed. I think that's part of signing day. But the thing I would tell you that rings true about this class is, you know, there are an enormous number of players that we signed today who chose to be at Delaware. There's an enormous number of people who came here, you know, that made the decision to come to Delaware, you know, over the teams we play, over teams that are in the MAC. And again, it makes you feel great about the university you're working with, and it makes you feel great about the quality of people that you had the opportunity to recruit. And again, we're thrilled. We're looking forward to, you know, continuing the relationships. Recruiting doesn't end because of signing day. You know, we'll be back on the phone with them and making sure that you know, we're getting them exactly what they need, so we give them the best possible competitive advantage, you know, as they come in here and enter into summer school. But we're thrilled. I mean, again, it's a third of our team, you know, so it's 33% of our scholarships are going to be coming in this class. And again, I couldn't be more excited. It's going to be a lot of fun, and it's going to be a good opportunity to coach a lot of young, talented, good players, and a lot of, you know, great opportunities for our current players to really help mentor and develop the young guys coming in. So it'll be a unique challenge and one that I think we'll be up to, and I know our players will be up to it, because the job they did recruiting and selling the program and the direction of the program was phenomenal. I couldn't be more proud of our current players and what they did and how they represented our program.
This is the the first year that you actually were able to do, you know, the recruiting and all that.
Mm-hmm.
How important was it, or how excited are you, I guess, to kind of like finally be able to put your stamp on the program as far as bringing kids in and stuff like that?
Well, again, it's exciting from a relationship standpoint. But as I told the seniors last year when I made a commitment to them, I'll tell you the same thing I told the freshmen that came in this year. There are no somebody else's guys, my guy, everybody's, they're all our guys. They're all Delaware football players. You know, I don't believe in that kind of thought process. I think it's divisive. I think it's negative. You know, everybody here is a Delaware player. They're all my guys, our guys, you know, in the program. So, am I excited about these guys? It's different because I've got a relationship with every one of these players. I've got a relationship with every single family. I've been in every single home of a player that we're going to take. You know, our coaches have been in their homes multiple times. You know, most players, we've been in their home the allowable number of times. You know, we're trying to turn over every stone and know everything about these guys, because it'll help us, you know, be able to understand, hey, how hard can you coach them? What do they need? What are their strengths? What are their weaknesses? So, you know, I think from the relationship standpoint, it's a little bit different. But I really liked the guys in the class last year. I think we got some good players. Some guys had to play probably before they were ready to play. But, you know, that's the way it goes. Some of these guys this year might have to play before they may be necessarily ready to play. You know, but it's our job to get them ready. It's our job to put them in better situations. So, again, I'm excited. I'm looking forward to it. It'll be a lot of fun. Today is a great day, you know, and we're going to have a great event here in about 45 minutes. And then we're going to go watch Monte, take it to somebody out there on the basketball court. So, you know, we're thrilled with what's going on here. Anything else? Appreciate you, man.